Hello, we continue with our unboxing videos. This will be an unboxing video where we present the Deye inverter. It's a very industrial and heavy piece indeed. This is an extremely sought-after brand at SOLARKIT's PV wholesale, not only in Hungary, but also in other countries in the region where we've sold many of these products. Combined with batteries, we are talking about a wide range of single-phase and three-phase products. Let's take a look at why we like the Deye brand and what's inside the box. It's one of the best value-for-money products in our current lineup. We are the largest wholesaler distributing it in Hungary, and we get it at an extremely good price across Europe, which allows us to sell it at a very competitive price. Considering its capabilities, it's a low-cost product, but it's highly versatile, packed with a wide range of technological innovations. It stands out because of its flexibility and the sheer number of features it offers for the price. Additionally, it has successfully entered niche markets that larger inverter manufacturers haven't been able to cover yet. So the Deye is a smart choice for users who value both innovation and affordability.
Or they couldn't cover these markets because the prices of other brands were too high. This is the best priced inverter and its accessories in our portfolio. In terms of value for money, it truly represents the best quality.
Why do we like this inverter? What does it offer?
The first thing we love about it is the battery voltage. You can connect any 48 volt battery to it.
You can connect any, but we have a recommended list showing which battery brands it can work with.
Yes, as you mentioned, there's a battery list. These are the batteries it can communicate with via a communication cable. But beyond that, there are the standard 48 volt batteries, like forklift batteries, that don't have communication, but the inverter can still regulate and operate the battery based on voltage. So really, you can connect any 48 volt battery. Of course, this should be approached with caution, but the option is there. That's definitely an advantage. Another great feature is that you can connect the generator directly to the inverter, so you can utilize its energy efficiently. Additionally, and this is quite unique, you can even connect the wind turbine directly to the inverter, which is something very few other inverter brands can offer. While this feature might not be used often, it's still a significant option for users who want more flexibility in their energy solutions.
It's worth noting that we hadn't installed a wind turbine system with this inverter yet, but that's exactly why you went to China. You spent 2 weeks near Shanghai in Ningbo at the factory where you completed a comprehensive on-site installation and service training. This way, we became the only company in Hungary capable of offering this solution. Now let's see what's inside the box.
So the first thing you take out is a small light box. Inside is the Wi-Fi antenna, which comes included, so there's no need to purchase it separately. This is the device that allows the inverter to communicate with your Wi-Fi network and connect to the monitoring system. It's an essential component that ensures smooth and reliable data transmission between the inverter and the system.
I assume these are the clamps in this smaller box.
Yes, there are three of them. We don't need to take them all out because they're all the same. A standard 100 amp current clamp. Size-wise, it's identical to the 100 amp clamps from other brands. It comes with a 3 meter factory cable, which can be extended.
As I understand, we don't need to buy a smart meter for this, am I correct?
It's not necessary, but the manufacturer also mentions that approximately 100 to 150 meters is the distance that can still be covered with extensions and the factory clamps. If the distance exceeds this range, it's recommended to install a smart meter, which will communicate with the inverter via RS485. This way, the smart meter can be placed further from the inverter without affecting the system's performance, ensuring smooth operation even over larger distances.
Great. We've shot several videos about the Deye brand, including one on a real installation site, which you can find on our channel. This is the mounting bracket that we use to mount the inverter onto the wall.
Yes, this is the mounting bracket. We attach it to the wall, the inverter sits on top of it, and it holds everything securely in place. It's a sturdy piece.
Looking at the product portfolio roadmap, it's clear that there will be a model refresh for this in 2024. The current design is more industrial and robust, but the updated version will feature a sleeker design with fewer visible screws and an overall more polished look.
Indeed, the upcoming version will be a more sophisticated product in the end. Also included in the box is a temperature sensor. This is used when, for example, you connect a 48-volt battery that doesn't have communication with the inverter. You attach the sensor to the top of the battery, and its role is to constantly measure the battery's temperature. If the temperature reaches a critical level, the system will automatically shut down to prevent any potential damage. This ensures both the longevity and safety of the battery during operation, even under extreme conditions. If the battery overheats, the inverter can stop charging or discharging it, acting as a safety feature.
Great. I should also mention that both the battery and the inverter must be installed indoors. They cannot be placed outside.
Yes, Deye doesn't currently have a battery that can be placed outdoors in temperatures below zero. All of their batteries are designed with the limitation that they cannot be charged if the temperature drops below zero. However, they are actively working on a solution, and it's expected that later this year they will release a new battery that will include built-in heating. This will make it possible to safely install the battery outdoors in colder climates. The package also includes the factory MC4 connectors, along with all the necessary screws, plugs, and cables needed for parallel communication. For example, here's a small yellow cable that we use when connecting multiple inverters. This orange cable is used to link them together. Let me pause for a moment because this is a common issue. People buy two inverters, try to connect them in cascade, and while they may physically connect them, the system doesn't work as expected. The key point to remember here is that Deye inverters can only be connected in parallel if both inverters are using the same battery. Without a shared battery, they cannot be connected in parallel. The battery is absolutely essential for this configuration to function properly. Another new addition in the past 6 months is that two small rings have been included in the box. These serve specific purposes. There is a larger and a smaller one. The larger ring needs to be placed inside the inverter housing and is used for the AC connection. It's essentially a magnetic ring that filters out noise from the cables coming from the AC side. The smaller ring, on the other hand, is used for battery communication or any other communication cables. The cable is fed through the ring, which helps filter out any interference or noise that could affect communication, ensuring smoother operation.
Again, here's the user manual, which we send as a PDF and is also available online. It's very important because it contains a lot of useful information, not just for residential users, but also for installers.
In my opinion, it's the most useful and user-friendly manual of all. It includes actual screenshots from the inverter display, with labels explaining what each menu and setting does. Honestly, this is the kind of user manual that even someone with no technical knowledge could follow and successfully install the inverter. I'm not exaggerating. I highly recommend that everyone reads through it, as it's incredibly helpful.
We've also made another video where you explain step by step in about 15 to 20 minutes how to set up the basics of the inverter.
Yes, and this unit has some weight to it. You can comfortably grab it and lift it out with a firm motion. In terms of size, it's clearly the most robust and largest unit.
This is the most versatile product in our portfolio, offering the widest range of features. It's likely this is the one you'll get the most questions about.
Yes, I should mention that its software and user interface require the most expertise. It's a bit more complex to set up compared to other inverters, so you really need to understand the system. That's why I highly recommend the video we made, where we go through every step, explaining what each setting does and how to configure everything. It's just like the user manual, with all the details included. Additionally, this thorough guidance ensures that even advanced users can fully optimize the system for their specific needs.
Let's not forget to mention that this inverter comes with an integrated backup box, and the current clamps are included, so you don't need to buy an external current transformer or smart meter. Norby, can you tell me, what else can it do?
Actually, the asymmetry it handles is the same as other brands. allowing it to deliver 100% nominal power across all three phases. It can deliver up to 50% of nominal power per phase, meaning a 10kW inverter can provide up to 5kW on a single phase. It can distribute the full 10kW across different phases, such as 5kW, 5kW and zero. It manages the load efficiently.
Can we also use it as an uninterruptible power supply?
Yes, if we take a look underneath, we can see that it has three AC connection points. One is for the grid, the second is for the load, and the third is for connecting the generator. So if we connect the grid and install the clamps, this setup can be easily implemented straight from the inverter package. You don't need any external devices or additional equipment. With this configuration, you can already achieve the classic zero export system. This makes it a very convenient solution since everything you need is included in the package.
Exactly.
However, this is still a zero export system that works only when connected to the grid. If there's a power outage, it will shut down unless you have a battery or load side connection. If you connect an additional load side consumer and have a battery, then it can operate in EPS mode, acting as an uninterruptible power supply, switching from grid to off-grid mode in less than 4 milliseconds.
Complete off-grid mode?
Complete off-grid mode, and if it has a battery and there are loads connected on the load side, it can easily manage to power your consumers during the day using solar energy. This way, it can supply energy to your consumers and charge the battery. Then, at night, it can operate solely from the battery.
Great, I think more and more people are looking for this now.
I would say there is the highest demand or interest in this for both residential and industrial systems, especially for those up to around 50 kilowatts.
It's interesting because the Deye brand and these hybrid three-phase or single-phase inverters with batteries are market leaders in places like South Africa. As I understand it, they are also widely used in Brazil and other countries where power outages can last for several minutes or even hours. These systems are used with both PV and generators.
And they are especially popular in regions like Africa because, as we mentioned earlier, you can connect almost any battery. If you have an old machine battery, you can connect it as well. So there's no need to buy an expensive new battery. Even with an old used battery, the system can still function as an uninterruptible power supply.
What other questions do we usually get about this, or is there anything else important?
Most of the questions are related to setup. Many times users turn on the inverter, provide power from both the AC and DC sides, thinking they've set it up correctly, but the inverter doesn't display any errors. It simply says it's on, but remains at zero output. The system is highly scalable, and you can connect multiple inverters and batteries. However, it's important to note that with Deye inverters, we're dealing with low voltage batteries. If you're building a larger system with multiple inverters and batteries, you need to account for significant amounts of cabling. For example, in a recent project for the Maltese charity service, we installed 50 kilowatt using 12 kilowatt inverters with 80 kilowatt of battery capacity. Each inverter has 4 5kW Pro batteries. The batteries are stacked, and we need to connect both the top and bottom of each battery to a DC bus bar, which collects all the positive and negative terminals. This DC bus bar then connects to all the inverters. The entire system is installed within a 4-meter space, and we use nearly 180 meters of DC cable to connect everything within that space. When you're working with large systems, cabling becomes a significant factor. This highlights the importance of detailed planning before installation. Without proper foresight, managing the cabling and connections could become a logistical challenge. Furthermore, the cost of additional cables and connectors can add up quickly in larger installations. It's essential to budget for these elements when designing complex systems. A well-planned cabling structure can save time and reduce costs during installation.
Great, good.
Good, that's it.
I feel that we've covered everything, or at least a lot, about the Deye inverter, and we wholeheartedly recommend it. For users who are looking for a solution that offers great value for money and plenty of features, this will be a perfect choice. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks. Let's check the batteries.